what is gospel music? It's more than just a sound. It's more than a genre. It's more than just a group of people worshiping passionately. It's more than a culture. It is the sound of the good news. See, I think the definition is found in those two words: music that spreads the love, transformative power, redemption, and change that comes when you know Jesus Christ. See, gospel music is kingdom music, and we've been called to represent. It was January 19th, 2022. And I found myself on the balcony of a hotel overlooking a vineyard. I was honestly hurting in a way that I never knew was possible. I was confused. I felt misunderstood. I was honestly in a place where I felt like maybe God was trying to do something that I didn't understand. I preached a message the Sunday before that got a little, it went a little viral. And all I was trying to do is show people how God would take our mess and actually use it for a miracle. But that moment for me turned into a mess. And all I could do in that moment was do what I've always done when I found myself in a valley. I worshiped. A few months before, I had come to the studio and we were supposed to be working on something different, and the Holy Spirit dropped this like Phil Collins, like double chorus reverb. And I was driving to 1519 and I just heard this huge like chorus and came in the studio and I was talking to Evan and I was like, hey, let's just scratch what we were supposed to do. I feel this thing. And we wrote this song called Available. And when I was on that balcony, I played the song probably 1,000 times. I didn't listen to anything else. It was the demo version of this song. And it literally kept me. Because the first lines of the song say, even before the beginning, you were Alpha and Omega. And when we wrote those words, I was like, I didn't have a real revelation until I went through fire. And in the second verse, it says, even when the fire surrounds me, you are my protection. even when death tries to hold me, you're the resurrection. I mean, the words of the song, I got goosebumps saying it right now. It literally kept me. And the grace of God that he would give me those words, that melody for the valley. I can literally remember sitting and looking over this vineyard that had no fruit on it. And every morning at 6 a.m., there would be a group of guys that came out as I was out there worshiping, and they had their shears and they were clipping on what looked like just branches. And in that moment, I remembered the word that God spoke in John, where it tells us that he is the vine and we are the branches. And it goes on to say that he prunes those that he loves because they're going to produce more fruit. My first time ever in a vineyard, no fruit around, they're cutting on it. And God spoke to me, he said, Michael, this is what I'm doing to you. I'm pruning you because I want more fruit. And it didn't seem fair. And it didn't seem right. And I didn't feel like I deserved it. But this is when I remembered that his ways are not my ways. And his thoughts are higher than my thoughts. And I had to trust him. And I know there's some people right now that have been treated unfairly. Things didn't go your way. It feels like, why is this happening to me? I'm coming here 2 years removed from the darkest, deepest moment of vacancy to tell you that God is looking for you to be available to him. Available doesn't mean that it always feels good. It means that it will always work out for your good. And I remember being in the shower and writing on the shower wall, 1 Peter 4:12-14. And it simply said, dear friends, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that has come on you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice in as much as you participate in the sufferings of Christ, so that you may be overjoyed when his glory is revealed. If you are insulted because of the name of Christ, you are blessed, for the spirit of glory and of God rest on you. If God asks, will you be available?
The dirt and you formed me, so you know what I'm made of. Made in your image, beautiful. Stained by my sin, but you atone. Grace falling down from the heavens. My life belongs to you alone. No matter where I go, you've been there. Your love is traceable. I'm available. I'm available. And when the fire surrounds me, you are my protection. Even when death tries to harm me, you're the resurrection. Made in your image, beautiful. Stained by my sin, but you atone. Grace falling down from the heavens. My life belongs to you alone, you alone. No matter where I go, you've been there before.
I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say to. Use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to say, my storage is empty. My storage is empty.
Come on, say,
my storage is empty. My storage.
One more time, say, my storage.
Say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
Y'all know that one?
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
What about this side? Do you know?
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Let me check this side. If you got a yes on the inside, everybody say,
yes, Lord, yes, Lord,
yes to your will, yes to your way.
Yes
to your will, yes to your way.
We gotta move, and this is why we can say yes to him. Come on, tell him why, Josiah. Lift it up, say.
Nothing ever possible for my God.
Nothing at all.
Nothing ever possible for your God.
Nothing at all.
Nothing ever possible for my God.
Impossible. Nothing at all.
Nothing is impossible for your God.
Nothing at all.
Nothing is impossible for my God.
Nothing at all.
About the song you just heard, Thy Kingdom Come, is that song was written by me and PC on the way to meet with Pastor Tim Ross in Dallas, Texas. We regularly go and just submit ourselves, tell him what's going on as he's our oversight pastor. And I knew that we were going to be talking about the kingdom of God. That was gonna be the word of the year. We decided we weren't gonna be kingdom, D-U-M-B. We were gonna understand the kingdom, D-O-M, have domain. And I said, I need to go down to Texas and talk through the theology and the concept. And we were reading Miles Monroe books and watching videos, and God dropped this song in my heart. I think Scott and Micaiah were with us, and I was in the front seat and I started humming this melody. It originally started out in 6/8, and then I went to the bathroom while Tim was ordering eggs and Charles was probably ordering some like wheat toast with avocado. And the Holy Spirit helped me finish this song in the bathroom. And I remember, Thy Kingdom Come. And I remember the da 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 da. And it was just so crazy. And I tell that story because I want you to know that when God drops something in your heart or in your lap, it is your responsibility to capture it. See, a lot of times when God is doing something, we are fumbling moments, ideas, thoughts, and even the breakthrough that we need for our future, it comes by capturing. You can ask my wife, every night I sleep with my phone right there with record ready because there's melodies and songs. And I want to encourage you, like as God is going to, I really believe, start dropping ideas and dropping thoughts and dropping books and dropping sermons and dropping cures into your lap. I want you to become a receiver. Yeah, like a football receiver. I want you to be ready to catch anything because you never know when God will give you the opportunity to bring something that is in heaven down here on earth. That's what the kingdom is about. As it is in heaven, let it come down here on earth, but it's going to come through. Somebody say me. Oh, come on. I said, somebody say it's going to come through me. And if we do not steward over the opportunities that God gives us, we don't get to see the fruit of what will bless so many other people. And that's why when it comes to this music thing at Transformation Church, Transformation Worship, we just let it flow. It's kind of like when we were in the studio one day and I told the guys, I was like, what if we did a worship song with nothing but 808s? And they looked at me and I was like, I don't know, I just feel it. Just go with me. Like, what if the main thing in the song was like an 808, boom, 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 boom. And like, what if we made it about the Holy Spirit? And I'm just saying these things. And it's as I begin to speak, it just started happening. The 808 started going, and then Caleb walked into the studio and I was like, bro, you got your talk box. And literally a song that may be my favorite song because it is the essence of representing. It's called Eagle. And that song talks about inviting the Holy Spirit in. It literally is a song that I believe can cross cultures, transform atmospheres. Why? Because you're saying, Holy Spirit, come down. Lord, we need you right now. There is no substitute. All we really need is you. We're in his presence, mounting up on wings like a, yeah, ego. Let's go.
Mounting up on wings like an eagle. Glory heavy, so I gotta let go of my
ego.
Got the Holy Spirit and we go wherever. That is my amigo. In his presence, mounting up on wings like an
eagle.
Glory heavy, so I gotta let go of my
ego.
Got the Holy Spirit and we go wherever. That is my amigo. Holy Spirit, come down.
Stretching my perspective to think high like a
eagle.
Did it my way, made mistakes, I wanna be where
eagle.
Tired of my ego. Nailing my flesh to the cross, no more of my
ego.
Getting out of your way, need your voice like a
eagle.
I surrender to your will, I can fly like a
eagle.
Wanna go where he goes.
can move and open the tomb and close with the wound. Yeah, we know. And all of my people, spirit of God is God, the Son is the eagle. Came on the Lord, the Lamb's the gold, but he coming back for the sequel. Out of the grave, out of this way. I got the cheat code, he don't make bacon. Fetching off chains, we call it evil. Thank God, remember me, though. Holy, holy, from the free flow. Come and do it, only you can do it. Let me go, Lord, free flow.
Funnest things about producing and curating sounds for Transformation Worship is there's no limit. Like, we can do Afrobeat, we can do CCM, we can do old gospel, and we can do like just fun songs. And I told the team, I was like, we need to do something top down, summer vibe, like barbecue. You can play this, people start doing the electric slide, but we need to talk about how high God is. And I was in the studio with my cousin Willie Jones and Evan, and we started, you the most high, you the most high God, you the most, and we just kept doing that, and it was like a vibe, and I was like, it needs to have kind of like a Bruno Mars feel at the chorus, like, it is, and y'all, this song about how God, I love the line that says, when I do the most, you're the most high God. Because I don't know about you, but sometimes if we've been actually being honest, how many people, raise their hands, who's watching this right now, have sometimes you've done the most? Come on, hands. Come on, hands. 17th row. If your hand is not up, you're lying. Okay? Like, sometimes we do the most. But aren't you glad that your posture and your practices don't change his position? Like, God is still higher than anything that seems above us. And once we started doing that vibe, we released this song in a soft launch, one of our first songs. And just for fun, I put out a challenge. And y'all, probably the third person that jumped on the challenge was Ty Demetrius Tribbett. Y'all, I don't even know if that's his middle name, but he, like, did the challenge, and people, like, in the comments, like, challenge over. Like, nobody's doing it anymore. Like, why did he have to jump on here? And it was just a vibe. And that day, it really blessed me. I've listened to Ty Tribbett for over almost 20 years. Inspired me musically. One of my musical heroes. Can preach the house down. He's been here at our conference and literally wrecked the house. And God has made us just connect, and to see him acknowledge our music really did something to me. And I was like, man, wouldn't it be cool if we could redo the song and Ty would actually be on the song? And y'all, we serve the Most High God. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? I was at the Stellar Awards. Ty Tribbett won like 17 Stellar Awards this year, was honored because his albums and his longevity has been amazing. And then he came to my room with the makeshift studio that we made, and I told him I wanted to do Most High, and he killed that. And so today, we gotta at least do that song. It's Album Sunday. How many people in this room know that you serve the Most High God? Transformation Worship. Let's go up.
Worship together, sing it out if you know it. We say,
breathe in, cause you're the source of life. When I'm in the deep end, drowning in the lies, I know I can't depend. Cause your word is not void. When I hear your voice, I get clarity through noise. Cause if it's above me,
come on, sing it out, say,
hey, I know that you love me,
say.
Cause in my safe place, say, all that I need is right here. Cause you're right here.
Come on, say, you're deep there.
When I do the most, you're the most high God.
You're drawing me close, Lord.
You're drawing me close,
but you're never that far away.
You're never that far.
Traded my chains for
our grace. Nothing can take your place.
It's in the most high God.
Son and the ghost, he the lion, the lamb, he the goat. And if you don't know, now you know. Every time I call him, any there, talking anytime, anywhere. Trouble all around with your court. Cause I know that Emmanuel is there. Yeah, tell me who can stand before us when we call them. Cause you are Jehovah. Everybody standing quite as tall. So line them up against them, they gon' fall. Everybody hands to the sky for the most high.
You're the most high God.
You're the most high God.
You draw me close, Lord.
You draw me close,
but you are never that far away.
Somebody worship him with me.
There is no one higher.
There's just nobody
than
like you, Lord.
There's, no one
there's just nobody greater,
than
nobody greater than
there's
Jesus.
No one higher than
there
you.
There is nobody
there's
else.
Just an option.
Hey, hey, hey.
You say I'm not forgotten.
Hey, hey, hey.
Just when I thought I lost him.
Hey, hey, hey.
He met me at the bottom. And I'm glad I found your love. I'm glad I found your heart. I'm glad I found your love. I'm glad I found your heart.
Come on.
I'm glad I found your love.
Hey.
I'm surrounded in your arms, my God, and nothing's gonna
morning.
Now, I know there's a few people that woke up and was like, I'm gonna just do my duty, I'm gonna go to church, and that's what good people do. That's not what we do here. We come to church, we lift our voice,
yeah.
We worship our God, because when we were a wretched mess and didn't care,
okay,
he snatched us out of this. Where are the people who are thankful for God's grace this morning? I know who I was. So today, I'm gonna just give everybody a chance to go ahead and take off your bougie jacket.
Stop playing.
Some of y'all, you're like, but my makeup. You were beautifully and wonderfully made before you put Mac on you. And some of y'all just got your hair done Thursday. It won't be done after today. But the Bible says the joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord. If you need strength today,
yeah.
If you've been being beat down by come anxiety, on. Depression, and feeling lonely, today I want joy to erupt in this place. You need to command your soul to bless the Lord today. So I'm gonna just give you a second to, now y'all know this groove feel good. If this was another song that you knew, you'd be like, ah, that's my jam. But we lifting up the name of Jesus in this place today. Anybody want to help me with it? Hey. Yeah, band, go ahead. Everybody just clap your hands. If you love them, just clap your hands. If you love them, just clap your hands. Hey.
If you love them, just clap your hands.
Hey.
If you love them, just clap your hands.
No matter where you're from. At home. If you love them. Tribute is here, right? Y'all acting like this is normal. Like, bro, the fact that you would come on a Sunday.
I love y'all, man. I wouldn't miss this for the world. What's up, Transformation? What's up, Transformation?
I can't tell you how many moments this man's music helped me be reminded that we serve the Most High God.
Yeah.
So this ain't fully planned out, but since he's here, I gotta say it like this. Hey, say,
if he did it before, he can do it again.
Come on, help me say,
same God right now.
Everybody say,
same God back then.
If he did it
you
before,
say,
if he did it before,
he can do it again.
He can do it again.
Same God right now.
Too good, bro.
You said that we're going through, for those people that's been going through hard times and tough times, encourage yourself and say, we gonna be all right. You say,
we gonna be all right.
Uh-oh. Tell your neighbor, tell your friend,
we gonna be all right.
Tell your neighbor, tell your friend,
we gonna be all right.
Uh-oh. Come on, lift it up now. Say,
we gonna
be all right.
For good.
We gon' be alright.
Tell me, can't brought me out. I knew he would.
We gon' be alright.
Yeah, hold your mouth. We gonna.
We gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright.
Hey, all things work together for good.
I feel a warfare spirit coming in this place right now. Hey, hey, hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey.
We gon' be up.
We gon' be up.
This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles.
Yeah.
This is how I fight my battles.
We gon' be up.
This is how I fight my battles.
We gon' be up.
Fight my battles.
Hey.
This is how I fight my battles.
Let's go.
This is how I fight my battles.
Something to say, Mike. We've been being doing for a night.
Only one night though.
We've been being doing for a night.
Only one night though.
Cry may last for a night, but we've been man doing for a night, but just
only one night though.
If you cry, you could cry one night, but just
only one night though.
Only one night though.
Only one night though.
If you cry, make sure that you cry.
Only one night though.
If you're sad, make sure that you're sad.
Only one night though.
If you're stressed, make sure that you're stressed. That's real high.
You got it though. Say,
joy comes in the morning.
You have to sing along.
Oh, take it low, take it low.
Go.
Just stay low, y'all.
Hey, joy comes in the morning.
Tell your neighbor, tell your friend.
Everybody say,
yeah. Joy comes in the morning.
Here comes the joy. Here comes the joy. Here comes the joy.
Joy comes in the morning.
Here comes the joy. Here comes the peace. Here comes the
joy. Comes in the morning.
Here comes the joy. Here comes the joy. Here comes the joy.
Radical worshipers are in this place this morning.
Though the night makes me weary, joy is coming, coming, coming.
When?
In the morning. All praise to King Jesus. I know joy is coming.
Say your neighbor, though the night may seem, you say,
though the stressing through the testing, man.
You better believe it by faith. There
I will
is
not
nothing
fear.
That can take
will
you
not
out. Say,
we
what you say? Right.
What you say?
If God be for me, who can be against me?
We gon' be alright.
They can leave, but He'll never leave.
We gon' be alright.
Yeah. Somebody to believe.
We gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright. Say we gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright.
From the front to the back.
I will not fear. What can men do to me?
I will not fear what can men do to me.
Get through this Sunday. Some of the people up there, y'all are looking at y'all crazy. They're like, why would they go down and praise like that? But there's some people in here, you got here a little late and you wish you could be down here. I feel you too. If you've never praised God undignified, and I know that some people think it don't take all of that, but what God did for me, where he rescued me from, how he brought me back from stuff that was so dark, I didn't want the closest people around me to know I was thinking and doing some of the, where are the real people at this? Like, I'm not talking about us putting on a facade to go to church. I'm talking about being real and raw before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who takes us just how we are. Today we're excited about this. I gotta do it one time, he's still here. Say everything.
Everything.
You're everything to me.
You're everything to me.
Everything.
Everything.
Come on, this is about Jesus. Will you lift your hands and just talk to him real quick? Say, you're
everything to me.
Everything.
Hey. Everything.
Come on, if you're at home, just lift your hands. Tell God. You're everything to me.
Everything to me.
Everything.
Everything.
Ty, I can't do it without you. Say, you're everything with me. Come on, lift it up. Talk to him. Say, everything.
Everything.
It's all about you, Jesus.
Hey, everything to me. You are
everything.
You are everything.
Everything.
Just you and Jesus. Close your eyes.
Life and breath.
Life
joy in sorrow.
Joy in sorrow.
Ooh, you're everything to me.
Everything
you
to
are
me.
Hope for tomorrow.
Hope for tomorrow.
Let's do it. 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 Come on. Come on.
Lift your voice and say, Master. Sick in your body, he is your healer.
Healer.
Hey, come on, say, deliverer.
Deliverer.
Let's call his name Jesus.
Jesus.
What's the one name that has all power? Say,
Jesus.
Who's there when everybody leaves? Jesus.
Jesus.
Who loves you more than you love yourself? Jesus. Sorry, Pastor Mike, I just had to...
Glory to God.
really believe that, just give him a huge shout of praise. Oh, come on, y'all. If there's nobody greater than our God.
Jehovah,
you are the Most High. You are the Most High God.
Jehovah,
you are the Most High.
Either y'all came to worship or not. Huh?
You are the
hands
most
lifted one more time. Say Jehovah,
you are the Most Woo! High.
We feel your presence
Jehovah,
in this place, God.
You are the Most High God.
Yeshua.
Come on.
Let's fill this place with his presence. Come on. Fill your words.
Yeshua.
It's all about him.
Up. Every time you say, Yeshua, sing it, y'all. Yes. Yes. Demons tremble at the name of Jesus. So every time you sing his name, something not like him is backing off your life, backing off your kids, backing off your marriage, backing off your finances. Sing his name. Disease is leaving. Viruses are leaving. Yokes are being destroyed. As we call his name, yeah. Say his name, yes, come on. For at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We lift your name. We lift your name up, and let the whole church come up.
service. He don't want you to walk out of here the same way. Say break, break, break,
break, break, break, break.
Every lie that you believed from a young child.
Yes,
today you're walking out of here. Break, break, break,
break, break, break, break.
Every generational trauma that tried to pass down in your bloodline. Break, break, break.
Cycles,
those walls are coming down. Well, when we worship on the word, we need biblical precedence for this. So I go to the word when there was a city called Jericho that the walls needed to come down. They walked around those walls seven times. And y'all remember we were saying, look at the way that I walk. And I think prophetically God was allowing you to walk around some things that have kept you in the dark for years. And God said, all right, now I need to change it, because the walk is not just enough. There needs to be a sound. You missed it. He said around the seventh time, I want you to drop what you have, and I want you to allow your sound to go up in the atmosphere. And it's at your sound. Somebody got it. Shout that you make.
He's the chain-breaker.
My shout can't bring your walls down, but your shout can.
He's the
on the count of three,
breaker.
I dare you to shout till the walls come down. 1, 2, 3. Depression, rejection, shame, it's coming down. Drug abuse, mental abuse, verbal abuse, it's coming. Confusion, false prophecy, manipulation, it's coming.
He's the chain breaker.
When I lift my voice and shout,
cause our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power.
Love, our God is an awesome God.
He's the one that does it. Just say,
our God is an awesome God. He reigns.
There's hunger in this
from
room.
From heaven above with wisdom, power, and love, our God is an awesome God.
Just one more time. God. Say, our God.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with.
You're a good God. You're faithful, you're strong, you're mighty. We put our trust in you. Said,
our God
is an awesome
God. Is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
God, we thank you that if not another song is sung, we sense and feel your presence in this place right now. Not just in this physical room, but in this moment in time, Father, whether people are watching online or watching in rebroadcast, your spirit has no limit. So I thank you that you're meeting every person where they are right now. And today we lift you up. It's great that we came out with songs, God, but you gave us the songs. It's great that we shouted unto you, but you gave us the breath. Today, God, we point everything back at you. Father, every place in my heart that is still hard, today I'm not going to wait till the end of service to repent. I don't need a group to help me do this, Father, because it's an inside job. I thank you that right now, any one of us who has had hardness in our heart, that is rejecting your nudging, God, I thank you that right now that there would be a sweet spirit that lovingly draws them. Yep, it's happening right now. There are people who've been long gone from God. You've been hurting, you've been mad at him. You thought he didn't care because of who you lost in your life at a young age. And today God's coming to bring you back. He. Because there is a sweet anointing in this sanctuary. Help me, Jaleesa. There is a stillness in the atmosphere. This is what you need to do. So
come lay down the burdens you have carried, for in the sanctuary
our assurance.
God is here.
Just one more time. Somebody's feeling that right there.
There is a sweet anointing in this sanctuary.
I feel you, God.
There is a stillness, say, in the atmosphere. So come lay down.
So come lay down.
The burdens.
The burdens you have carried.
I believe, for in the sanctuary.
God is here. Just clap your hands one more time in this place. Amen. Hey, y'all take y'all seat just for a second. It's not over. Even my people at the front, you're not going to lose your... I mean, y'all can stay up here. Y'all ride or die right here. I like y'all. Okay, just stay right here. Just stay with me. I appreciate what God's doing in this moment, and I'm trying to be very sensitive to what's happening. I believe this is an atmosphere of healing. No, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Like, you thought this was about to be music. But God's about to remove layers off of your life. Somebody say, I receive. Yeah. No. See, when God says something, you can deny it. You can put your hands up. But when you hear something that agrees with your faith, I want you to say, I receive. Somebody's going to be healed today. Somebody say, I receive. Somebody's going to get vision for their life. Somebody say, I receive. You say, Pastor Mike, you just saying stuff. I'm saying stuff he says in the word. Like there's certain things that are his promises. That sometimes our doubt and unbelief, they block it. But today I just want you to open your heart and just somebody just, whatever you have for me, God, somebody say, I receive. Well, I want to welcome you to Transformation Church, where we don't really apologize for worshiping God. If you love your church, make some noise in this building. Come on. Amen. If you went to your favorite country star or pop or R&B or hip-hop artist and it was like dull energy, you would be like, I can't believe I paid for this. Girl, this is the most mid situation I ever been through. You would be doing, but somehow when you come into church, the enemy tries to reverse it and say it doesn't take all of that. But when you see how detailed God is with just painting the sky, why don't you think that type of God deserves our full praise? There's some fellas in here that you trying to sneak and watch the game on YouTube TV right now. And you going, oh, I'm in your business. And you getting updates, your thing is buzzing every 2 minutes to see. They still gonna lose. But what I'm telling you, there's nothing wrong with that. Except if you're more enthusiastic for a bunch of men and a team and a color who don't know you than the God who died for you. So today we're just trying to create the atmosphere for God to do something. Well, if this is your first time or your second time or your third time, or honestly, I've been gone and I'm glad to be back and see everybody here. Like, I love you. I just want to say welcome to Transformation Church, where we exist to represent God to the lost and found people. What does that mean, Pastor Mike? There are people in here that believe what you believe. That's cool. But the thing I get excited about is there are people in here that don't believe nothing we believe. And they blazed up before they got in here. And they was like, I ain't been to church since my mama, and that just gave me anxiety. And they drank something before they came in here. And they were with somebody doing something last night that they wasn't supposed to be doing. And we welcome you here. I said, everybody is welcome at this church. And what I just did is I offended religious people. Because they want church to be a club for the people who do good. But the Bible tells us all have sinned. and falling short of the glory of God. So I just want to welcome everybody. And if this is your first time, I want you to do something real quick. I want you to pull out your phone, and you can text the number on the screen, 828282, and you're going to text welcome. And we got something for you. We want to get a little information from you, and we want to give you something. And I believe that with less than almost 100 days left in this year, this still could be the best year of your life. Somebody said, I receive. Now, these people, they checked out of here. But I said, with less than 100 days left in this year, this still could be the best year of your life. Somebody shout, I receive, yeah. But that means we got to listen and obey and stay plugged into what God wants for us. And being in the local house of believers is one of those things that allows people to stay connected. And so I'm grateful for every person that's here today. What I actually want you to do is I want you to come back next week. This week we're worshiping the whole service. But I've been on sabbatical, and I've been with God. And my soul is rested. Now, people don't understand what that means, but like my mind, will, and emotions have been allowing God to change and transform me. And some of the things that changed our church were series that came right off of sabbatical. Relationship Goals was right off of sabbatical. Crazy Faith was right off of sabbatical. Damaged But Not Destroyed, right off. God gave me these revelations. Y'all, I got a new sermon series for y'all. I'm not gonna reveal what it is yet, but everybody here got to come back next week. And those who are watching online, because you can't be here physically because you're somewhere else, I need you to be tuned in and gather people, because the next 3 months is going to change our next 3 years. Y'all the only ones that got I receive. God, don't. I said the next 3 months of revelation, wisdom, and obedience is going to change the next 3 years of our life. I received that. And I want you to hear it. I want you to hear it raw. I want you to hear it how God's given me, and it's going to help us walk out this thing. And so I'm so excited about it. I have to give God praise for our amazing team that, while I was gone for almost 2 months, didn't just hold things down. They took it to another level. Can we thank God for this amazing team, staff, volunteers, children? Y'all got to do better than that. The musicians, the glory to God, every usher, every sound tech, every parking lot. See, a lot of people think that this church is built on my personality, but from the very beginning, we said it will not be built on the personality of one. It will be built on the sacrifice of many. Ain't no way I could pull this off by myself. God has sent so many of you, and I just want to say thank you. And I got to shout out all the speakers we had. Pastor Travis Green and Bishop Kevin Wallace and Dr. Auntie Anita Phillips and Pastor Joel Tudman and Lyle Phillips and Pastor Charles. Yes. And Pastor Roosevelt. Did you? Yo. It's great to be on a team full of people who don't just play a role that, if the moment calls from it, they can take the winning shot. And we want to lift people, and I'm just grateful to this amazing congregation. After service today, I told the team, I said, I got to go hug people. I'm an extrovert, and y'all done had me away from people for 2 months, and people I know since COVID, everybody's like, ew, not me. I love you. And I love hearing about your stories. And how many people traveled here from out of town? If you came from... What? Where did y'all come from? Shout out where you came from. Maryland. Where? Wisconsin. Baltimore. What? Hold on, it's a whole group of people. Y'all stand up. Where'd y'all come from? They came from Brazil to come to church. Glory. Oh, y'all, come on, man. Who? Hold on. Somebody help me. What? I know this is breaking all the stuff. Why y'all here? They've been traveling and they've wanted to come see Transformation Church. And our pastors, is this pastors? Transformation Church, how do we welcome our friends, not just to our church, but to our country, to our city? We love you. How great on Kingdom Sunday. We love y'all, man. Wow. Oh, now I'm emotional. Oh, shoot. What'd you say? From Hawaii? Don't be standing there quiet from Hawaii. You're like, Hawaii. Thank y'all for coming, man. Mexico? Now, hold on. Are y'all just shouting out where your mama name is from? Or are y'all actually shouting out where you live right now? Okay, Jersey in the house. I love it, baby. Hey, listen, wherever you came from, stop yelling. Wherever you came from, we're glad that you're here. And I'm not yelling nobody else's name. Be quiet. I'm just grateful, man. You never know when God asks you to do something if it's really going to work. Because we walk by and not by. So sometimes you do it just because God says to do it. But when you see people from Brazil and Hawaii and Jersey and wherever that person that I didn't call out said they're from, it just takes me to a place of gratitude. And so I'm just thankful. Hey, after church, we'll be in the lobby and we want to meet you and we want to hug you. I can't meet everybody and hug everybody. And some of y'all's stomach going to be fighting you by the end of that. And so you just going to leave. So, but for anybody who wants to come, I want to say hello. Next week, we start a new series. And I don't know if you knew, but this past Friday, Transformation Church released the album called Thy Kingdom Come. And super grateful for your support. I have one ask with this, is that if this music that you hear today, if you like it just a little bit, like if one song, like it's like, okay. Like if you do that to one song, I want you to actually go support it. It's one of those things that's crazy. Like everybody tells the church what they need to do, but won't support it. Like Christian movies are whack, but when they put them in the movie theater, you won't go see it. So their budget is smaller than Transformers because we don't support because of, watch this, principle. They need to entertain me. What we need to do is support because of principles so that we can sow a seed that grows it into something else. If you haven't seen the movie The Forge, has anybody seen that? I'm encouraging Transformation Church, and I've never publicly endorsed a Christian movie before. That movie is phenomenal. And you don't need to just stream it or go to your bootleg service on the internet. Oh, because, yep, some of y'all, he said, I got to go. I need you to go support it. Why? Because if we support the things that the kingdom is doing, we can get better products in the kingdom. And so I'm going to just ask you, this is our third album in 6 months, and it might be one of my favorite. Yeah, you can give God praise for that, y'all. This team has worked amazingly. Can we give it up for Transformation Worship? And y'all, come on, man, this is us. And if nothing else, it's $5.99 if you go to therepresentstore.com, and it's $9.99 on iTunes. I want you to go get this. I'm honestly talking right now to give y'all a break. Because y'all know what's about to happen. Y'all have no idea. Some of them like, thank you, Pastor, for giving me a break. These 42-year-old needs need a break, Pastor. Thank you. We're about to start back up. Michael Todd, bro, I love you, dog. Hey, man, this dude has been following Transformation Church and been a part of this from California, him and his beautiful wife for years. I see you in the building. I saw your muscles, actually. I'm proud of you. Love you, man. Hey, yeah, I'm on your way to where you at, brother. I love you. My heart is filled. Thank you for being a part of what this is. We're going to give right now. And this is something like somebody just got uptight right there. And wait, hold on. You ain't even got to clap because at Transformation Church, we have taught about giving. And then it's just a decision. No manipulation, no prayer. And some of y'all are here and you're like, all right, where's the offering bucket? We ain't got one. I made a decision 10 years ago that I would teach about giving and honoring God with our resources, and then I would put no pressure on people because either they believe it or they don't. And in a lot of churches, like, if you need a miracle, you need 33 miracles, lift your hands, give $33.33, and you're going to get a miracle at 3:33, and look at your microwave and warm your noodles up for 3 minutes and 33. Like, they... And all that is manipulation. Some of it has been transferred. Some people that do it, it's not a wrong heart. But we ask people to just ask God, God, am I supposed to give something? And if you ask God, our culture code here is generosity. We give just to give and not to get. There's a byproduct of giving that's in the word, that when you sow seed, he will actually do something. It's got to have a harvest. But that's not why I'm doing it. I'm doing it because I love him, I honor him, and he gave for me first. So that's why I honor. So some of y'all who are new are part of it, like, okay, so how do we give? You can give with the QR code on the screens. Most of us give by online and stuff like that. But there's a bunch of white boxes outside that are very discreet that literally, if God gives you something, put it in there and know that Michael's not going to reward you. Transformation Church is not going to reward you. The God who sees your sacrifice, who knows your issues, your bills, your greed. He knows everything about me. He's the one that's going to reward you. And so today I'm going to pray for everybody around the world. Watch this. Who has been faithful for years. There's no way we could do this. This is a paid off building. We got over 100 staff. Like, y'all don't even, like, we've given over $1 million away this year. How do we do that? It's because there are faithful people that don't have to be pumped, primed, and convinced that God is faithful when it comes to trusting him. Not just with our heart, but with our resources too. So I'm going to pray for everybody that's in that moment right now. And then we're going to go into the next song. And I believe God is going to meet us. Father, thank you. Thank you that you are the God that knows all, sees all, and has all. Today, God, we're asking you to have your way as we give. Sacrificially, many of us, we know what the economy says, we know what our job should pay us, we know all of those things, but Father God, no matter if it's famine or feast, we will trust you. Thank you, Father, for the faith to believe. Have your way in this place today, and bless every person who had a desire to give as well as the ability to give today. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise in Jesus' name. Somebody say, we agree. Amen. I want you to turn your attention to the screen as we go higher in worshiping our God.
It's 5 a.m. We're on the way to the birthing of you. We're excited, son. We're going to get to meet you today. We have just packed up the car, and your mom is saying it's not safe, which it's not. You should never record and drive, but we're just excited about seeing you. Mom, how you feeling?
Watching the road. I'm good.
In probably like 2 to 3 hours, we'll get to meet you, so we're super excited. We're just believing God that everything that he promised when you were John, when you were born, it's gonna happen. So we love you. Just documenting the time.
October 26th, 2015. My son. My only son. Michael Alexander Todd Jr. Born perfect. It's so crazy to think back on that day. When we started that day with prayer, our doctor, our family around, we dedicated that boy to God before he was even on this earth and took his first breath. And throughout his development, it was just beautiful watching him start to walk and start to say words. And it was about when he was
a year and a half that Natalie came to me one day and said, do you notice that MJ's looking at me less? And I was like, nah, I mean, you know, it's all good. And my mama knows. She started to sense and see him regress, where he would have used to look straight at and use his words and say things. He was staring off into space more and not communicating, not connecting, isolating. And I remember when Nat said, I know something's wrong with my baby. And we took him to a therapist. And she told us to sit to the side and she was gonna test MJ. And we watched as he ignored her, as she tried to contact him, connect with him. And then she told us, yep, it's definite. He is autistic. And she began to list all the things that he would never do. And at that moment, my heart broke, but I think it paled in comparison to watching my wife's heart to be ripped out. I'd never seen such despair. And being the man of crazy faith and walking and telling people to believe, this would end up being the test of my life. To watch my son be labeled and watch my wife be disabled and me standing in the middle trying to have faith for our family, preaching every Sunday and full of questions. It was about 2 years that went by where we were just stunned. Didn't know what to do, didn't really know how to help, tried all kinds of things, but we needed a miracle. And I remember Ava was just born, and I was sitting at the piano in my makeshift studio in the dining room of our house, and I was broken. At a moment we should be celebrating the life of our brand new baby, I could tell that there was still so much grief in our home. And God said, Michael, you know me as a healer. You know me as a waymaker. You know me as a miracle worker. But I want to introduce a new side to you. And as I was sitting at that piano, God told me, he said, Michael, I'm a sustainer. And in that moment, it was like something dropped on the inside of me to know that God won't just see you through a situation, he'll sustain you in the situation. See, everybody doesn't get a miracle that happens overnight or even a miracle that is like, oh, it's gone. Sometimes the sufferings of this life, the pain of disappointment, the grief of losing stays with you. And what do you do when money doesn't work, when accolades don't do anything, when a bigger house doesn't make it better, when having more people around you still leaves you feeling empty? You have to rely on the only one who is the anchor through every storm. His name is Jesus. And in that moment, I begin to pen these words, you sustain. You sustain. In the middle of it all, you remain the same. Through the rain, you still reign. You sustain. And the part that really got me through is when he said, your promises always come true, not dependent on me, because I was trying to make it happen. I was trying to be the savior. But God told me that my promises always come true, not dependent on me, but relying on you, because your mercies are new every day. So this is our response. I will trust you. Since that moment, that song has sustained me. Because the God that I sing the song to is the sustainer. And I don't care what you're going through right now. I don't care if you find yourself in the middle of a storm. I want you to know I am a living witness. Natalie is a living witness. Our story is not over with MJ. We are still continually walking through. But the miracles that we have seen and how God has sustained us, I'm talking about time after time, time after time. He has defied every odd. What they said he will never do, he is doing. As a matter of fact, he just started first grade, and in his class, I gotta tell y'all this because I got a praise report. When they said he would never go to school, he is going to school. And as he started his first grade, he had his first spelling test. And as a father, I didn't know how he was gonna do. He's been in controlled atmospheres. And we found out that MJ made the only perfect score on his spelling test. He got 102 on his spelling test, and he is progressing beyond our wildest imagination. Why? Because God sustains. Today, I want to let you know he's a keeper. And our story is just us being available to let you know that God can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you can ask, think, or imagine. Because God, I know you sustain.
Everything is possible for the one who believes. I believe.
Yes, sir.
If you know his word is keeping you alive, can you shout in here today? If you know you serve a sustainer, can you lift up a sound of worship in this room? Hallelujah. We lift this up and declare it to you. We say,
holding on to your word, it's the light in the dark, the hope for my heart. Oh, seasons come, people change, but you were there at the start. You won't leave at this part.
Sustain, say, you sustain, you say, yeah,
in the middle of it all, you remain the same through the rain, still you reign, you sustain, we say, letting go,
of all fear.
I'm leaning on you, and I trust what
Sickness. sustain. Can we sing it again all together? Come on, say, you sustain.
You sustain.
You do, you do.
You sustain.
Right in the middle.
In the middle of it all.
You.
You remain the same through the rain.
Still you reign.
Still you reign.
You sustain.
You sustain.
You hold me up. You sustain. You hold me up.
You sustain.
You hold me up, you do.
You sustain.
You won't let me fall, you hold me up.
You sustain.
You won't let me drown,
you hold me up.
Hey, you sustain. Come on, say,
you hold me up.
Oh Lord, you.
You sustain.
When I feel like falling,
you hold me up.
When I feel like throwing
you
in the towel,
sustain.
You hold me.
You hold me up.
Say,
one more time, sing, y'all.
You sustain.
Lift it up.
You sustain.
You're talking to your Father.
In the middle of it all.
Abba, here we are.
You remain the same through the rain. Still you reign. You sustain.
I am the Lord.
Come on.
That healeth thee. Lift your hands if you need healing. Yes, I am the Lord, your healer. And I sent my word to heal your disease. I am the Lord, your healer. Make it personal, Rose. Say, he is the Lord that healeth me.
He is the Lord that healeth me.
He is the Lord, my healer. He sent his word,
yes,
to heal my disease. Forever he is the Lord, my healer. He is the Lord. Y'all, excuse me, I'm believing God for a miracle.
Jaleesa, somebody needs to hear this. Lift your hands all over the world and receive right now. He will heal.
He is the Lord.
Yes.
That healeth you.
Yes.
He is the Lord. Your healer. Oh, he sent his word.
My God.
To heal your disease.
Oh, Jesus.
He is the Lord.
Oh, yes, he is.
Oh, yes, he is.
I receive this healing.
He is.
Yes, he's a healer.
I believe he is.
I believe you can do what the doctor said that nobody can do. I said we serve a healer.
Woo.
He sent his word.
Yeah, yeah.
To heal every disease. I know they say there's no cure for this, but I declare right now, he is the Lord. Right there in ICU, I speak it. I speak, he is the Lord. Yeah, 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 yeah. He is, he is. You got to will yourself. You got to encourage yourself. He is the Lord. They say he won't survive. They say he won't make it, but he is the Lord.
If you know that we serve the healer, why don't you lift up a shout of praise in this place? Uh-oh. This thing can turn ugly real quick, because we serve the healer.
I know he will.
I know he will.
I know he
is.
If you know he will, why don't you just give him one shout of praise right now? Situation right now. Somebody just turn around. This is what I believe prophetically. God's turning the marriage around. He's turning the finances around. He's turning your mind. He's turning the
He's turning it around.
Hey, I said he's turning it around. Some of y'all won't even do the prophetic sign, but I said somebody turn around. This is just a prophetic gesture. You gonna go home this week and that relationship is turning. He's turning it around for your family. He's turning it around for your children. You won't be depressed the rest of the year. He's turning it around.
Oh, yes, he is. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory.
He's turning it around.
We serve a God that'll turn it around.
He's turning it around. Watch him turn. Watch him turn.
Watch him turn.
Find a neighbor and say, watch him turn it.
Watch him turn it.
You don't gotta believe, but as for me and my house,
watch him turn.
As for me and this house,
watch him turn.
As for me and this house, watch him turn it. There's somebody online. Your whole situation is turning around right now. So I got one question. When he does turn it around,
come on, come on. What you gonna do?
What's gonna be your response?
He
Jaleesa,
touched it.
The problem is, many of you wait till he turns it around to do anything. That's not faith, that's a response. But today, if we walk by faith and not by sight, I just want you to take 5 seconds and I want you to respond right now. Like that thing that's been on your heart and on your mind has just turned around. 1, 2. Is that gonna be your response? When he changes your situation, you don't gotta shout. But I dare you to let a praise come up out of you that don't care about what the person next to you thinks. Give God praise. Did y'all hear me? Say,
the devil thought he had me.
Just one more.
The devil thought he had me.
Thought that my life was
over.
He thought my now I'm
giver.
He thought I had no
Lord.
But that's what someone
greater
stepped in my situation.
One more time, and if we don't rip the roof off of this place, you don't believe God's really gonna do it. Just one more time, somebody turn around. Just turn around. This is what's about to happen in your situation.
Yeah.
This is what's about to happen in your family.
Turn.
This is what's about to happen in your finances.
Turn.
The devil
thought he thought that my life was
over.
He thought by now. You had no
hope,
but that's when someone stepped in your situation. Your money has a
shout, he turned it, yeah.
Oh, yes, he did.
Yeah,
he turned
it. Okay. All right. Hey. Gotta move on. Whoa, there's something right there trying to hold us.
Hey.
Okay, so, give me 3 minutes to preach to you. I'm gonna preach to you in 3 minutes.
Jesus.
I'm gonna preach to you in three. How many minutes, Isaiah? I'm gonna give you three, maybe five, but just give me three. Okay, listen.
Somebody say, God's gonna turn it. Say it with faith. Somebody say, God's gonna turn it. Like, I really do believe God's about to turn your situation. Somebody say, I receive. Okay. The thing that many times we're not prepared for, listen. The thing that many times we're not prepared for is how long he takes to turn it. Okay, can we be honest? There's a difference between turning a bicycle and turning a cruise liner. When you like, oh, I'm going the wrong way on a bike, you just flip around. But if you're on a big ship, like with like basically a city on the water, if they decide to turn around, it takes time. And what if people on the boat started jumping out because the turn didn't happen as fast as they thought it should? When I was on the boat that could only fit me, it just whipped around. But this thing that God has called many of us to is not just us. It's bigger than us. And some of us get frustrated because we don't know how to wait. And today, I'm encouraging somebody that was about to jump off that situation, jump into the wrong situation. If I stay with the analogy, some of y'all about to jump into shark-infested water. Because it pays more. Okay, all right. Because you're worth that. And God's saying, where did I ask you to be? I told you I was going to turn it, but you got to realize that for some things, the children of Israel, they had literally their lives transformed. But God said, I'm going to intentionally take them the long way. There's a shorter way to do this, but I got to take them the long way to watch this process out of them what can't go into the promise. And what waiting many times does is it processes out of us ambition that is not from God. It processes out of us those ideas and thoughts that didn't come from him but came from our trauma. God says, you need time. The truth of the matter is, you don't want everybody to see you in this state. You need this time to let me refine you. And I don't know about you, but sometimes I'll be like, God, would you just hurry up? Oh, am I the only one in this place that like, hurry up? You know how much when I read creation, one day you created a lot in a day. Could you just do a turn around? But many times what God is doing is waiting on us to actually listen and obey. Many of us have journals filled with things we have not actually done. And we show up to the water fountain again looking for fresh water. And God said, you're still not going to drink it. Today, I'm asking every person in this room that if God brings you into a waiting season, I want you to wait. Watch this with expectation. Today might be the day that God begins to do, watch, not the final thing, just a new thing in me. Somebody say, I want God to do a new thing in me. It's the small things that God continues to do in our lives that end up in a big result. And I found out in my life, God needed to, watch this, teach me how to wait. Because when you wait, he's so good. He doesn't just make you wait like it's something that's a punishment. He says, if you wait on me, I'll give you something that's better than what you could even imagine. If you wait, I'll give you strength. And I was like, hold on, God, why would you give me strength when I wait? Because he said, this is the place where you're not relied on yourself. I'll give you what you can't get if you would just wait on me. And today, in my life, and in your life, and in our life, I believe that God wants us to be one of those who say, however long it takes,
no matter what you need to do, I'm going to wait on you with the right heart, with the right, watch this, vision. And I'm not going to move until you speak. On this album, we wanted to write a song that was really a meditation song that I've played probably 1,000 times. That helps me understand that when I wait, God gives me new strength. And today, all over the world, I'm gonna ask the team to sing this song, but I'm asking you to put your heart at a position of rest. I know some of y'all busybodies, y'all just, and then I gotta do this, and then I, and your calendar, and your planning, and your all that, and God's like, yo, I lead you beside still waters. And don't make me, because I'll make you lie down. Uh-oh, y'all not ready for that. A good shepherd will make the sheep lie down in green pastures. And some of you, the things are not working because you won't listen. You're trying to do another thing. And God said, just lay down. Rest in me. I got this. That's why worry proves you have faith. Because all worry is faith in the wrong direction. You believe so much that the bad thing's going to happen, that it continues to cloud your mind. God says, you got faith. Just turn it towards me and wait on me. Today, I believe God is going to minister to you as we meditate and we wait on the Lord.
When I wait, I get new strength, brand new faith, brand new vision. Oh, I keep soaring with you. You keep seeing me through. 'Cause you are so, so good. That's why I wait on you. I wait on you. Lord, I wait on you. Shaking, for your promises are sure. Be still my soul and see the goodness of the Lord. I won't be shaken, for your promises are sure. Be still my soul and see the goodness of the Lord. 'Cause you are so, so good. 'Cause you are so, so good. That's why I wait on you. I wait on you. I wait on you. I wait on you. Through the storm, I wait on you, Jesus. You are with me.
I'll wait on
when I get empty.
I'll wait on you.
No, I won't move.
I'll wait on
so greater is in me.
I'll wait on
you're writing my story.
I'll wait on
your presence is plenty, God. No, I won't move.
I'll wait
so I won't get weary. Jesus, 'cause you are with me. And when I get my story, your presence is plenty. No, I won't move.
I'll wait.
Jesus, no, I won't move.
I'll wait.
I'll command my soul to be still. I'll wait. Ooh, I won't move.
I'll
wait on you. I won't move.
I'll wait.
Cause I know I keep sewing with you. You keep seeing me through. Jesus, I'll wait on you. Through the pain, I'll wait on you. Yeah. Through the storm, I'll wait on you. Yeah. Come on, with hands lifted, just help me sing that. Oh, I'll wait on you, say. Come on, sing, I'll wait on you, say. It don't matter what it look like right now. It don't matter what it feel like right now. Cause I know when I wait, you're giving me no strength, Jesus. Hey, you're giving me no vision, yeah. When I need clarity, oh God, oh, I'll wait, yeah. Oh, I'll wait. I'll wait on you, God. Oh, I'll wait on you, God. It don't matter if my strength is failing.
One time, could you say that? Say, I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord.
Cause you know best.
I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord.
Here. They that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings like an eagle.
Hey,
and soar. They shall walk.
Hey,
not get weary. They shall run and not faint. That's what happens when you wait.
I feel somebody's faith coming to them right now. Say that again. Say that.
They that wait on the Lord,
on the Lord,
shall renew the strength.
They shall mount
up on wings.
Somebody's strength is coming back.
They saw it.
You're looking at a miracle.
But I'm looking at miracles in the room.
Hey,
if you have breath in your body,
say it.
If you have the,
you're looking at a miracle.
The activity of your limbs, that means that God is right in the middle of your situation. I don't know what you're facing.
You're looking at a miracle.
He's looking at a miracle.
Hey, that's why we gotta just say it one more time. I have faith to believe.
I have faith to believe. You have all that.
Say,
I'm a believer.
If you're a believer in this room, that leads right into this last part of the service. That there are some people in this room who are not believers, that have not experienced the love and grace of God. And today, this whole day would be worth nothing if I didn't give an opportunity for people who are far from God to come close to Him. Now, it hasn't been that He's far from you. It's just that the Bible tells us that we have to believe what His Son did and accept it. Somebody say, I receive. Yeah. And this is the part where I know you're trying to leave and get to your restaurant and get your parking spot, but I'm telling you, this is the most important part of the service. Because when we say, thy kingdom come, Jesus preached one message. Repent. Because the kingdom of God is at hand. One message. He wanted people to become believers. And today, if you're watching online, you're watching on rebroadcast, you're in the room right now, today I want to give you an opportunity to accept Jesus. It was the greatest decision I ever made. It took me from being a liar, a manipulator, addicted to pornography, had a lot of very evil and dark things in my heart, and it transformed my life. How do you say that, Pastor Mike? Because I know who I was, and some of y'all playing me, but you know who you were too. But the grace of God. That's why I'm a believer. Because it was the blood of Jesus that bought me. Say, I'm a believer. And every person in this room, you need to step into this grace and be able to say, I'm a believer. Woo! This is your moment to be able to declare, I'm a believer. Yes, I believe in you. That's what I want for every person. I want you to believe in him, not Pastor Mike. I'm gonna mess up sometimes. Not your husband or your wife. They're gonna make mistakes and disappoint you. But Jesus is the only one who can take everything that you are now, and he can work that mess around, take stuff out of it. And then when somebody looks at your life, they'll say, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. And you know what you made of. My ingredients don't taste like what you, Today, if you're in this room and you want to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, I need to make a disclaimer. This is not for young people. I need to say this because a lot of times when we come into church atmospheres, the salvation part is for the people who've never heard. Like the young people need to hear. That's why I bring my kids to church, because they need to hear this. Woe to the one who hears the word and becomes desensitized or denies it over and over. Today, you may have heard or been a part or even given altar calls or salvation moments, but today you need to receive. Somebody say, I receive. In the gym, at your home, in this building, I want everybody to just close your eyes just for a second. And if Jesus was to come tomorrow, not the question is, would you be perfect? Because none of us would. The question would be, have you put your trust in Jesus Christ? And if you are unsure of that, if you would need to start explaining or qualifying, today I want to give you an opportunity right now in this moment. I feel the presence of God to make Jesus Christ your personal Lord and Savior. On the count of three, if that's you, I just want you to slip your hand in the air. And I'm talking about if you're in this room, in the balcony, if you're at home, it doesn't matter. If somebody sent you this, if you're watching it, and somebody you love is watching it, but you kind of distracted in the back, this is the moment. The Holy Spirit has been drawing you all week to this moment right here. If you want to make Jesus Christ your personal Lord and Savior, one, you're making the greatest decision of your life. Two, your name is about to be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. I already see hands. Three, shoot your hand up in the air right now. If it's you, I see you. 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 And more than I see you, God see you. Transformation Church, let us erupt in praise. Oh, and join all of heaven. Hey. Church, we're a family. Nobody prays alone. Would everybody stand all over this building? We're about to go home, but this part gets me real excited. Oh my God, heaven is rejoicing, turning up over one soul who gets saved. And I saw tons of hands in here, and I know there was more online. Y'all, this is the kingdom coming to earth. Everybody just lift your hands for the benefit of those who are coming to Christ. Say, God, thank you for sending Jesus just for me. Today, I give you my life. I believe you lived, you died, and you rose again with all power to defeat everything I've ever dealt with. Here's my life. I'm yours. Change me. Renew me. Transform me. I'm yours. In Jesus' name, amen. Can we celebrate all over this building? Oh, come on, this should be the biggest shout of the day. Welcome.
to the family. Welcome to the kingdom. If you made that decision, there's a QR code on the screen. And we want to give you some information. And I'm asking everybody, come back next week. God's about to do something special. Now, y'all the people that leave before the extra credit in the movies. I see y'all. I see y'all. Oh, hold on, wait. I got to, hold on, wait. I'm telling you, we got one more song left. Has anybody enjoyed Thy Kingdom Come album Sunday? Now, we're about to turn up, so if this is your point that you wanted to come to the front the whole time, this your chance. Come, y'all turn around and invite somebody. Invite somebody. Tell them to come on down. Come on down. Yeah, come on. Thank you to this amazing team. Can we give God praise for Transformation Worship and the amazing band? And y'all been killing all day. Can we thank God for Ty Tribbett? My brother, my sister Shante, my little niece, I love y'all so much. We're just grateful for you. My big cousin Kelvin, I love you, boy. Would you, hey, should we go on tour?
Yes.
A Transformation and Ty Tribbett tour would be crazy. Speak those things. We a church of crazy faith. You are here. What if we pulled up in LA and did this? And then went to Miami and did it. And
somebody said Louisiana.
One of the ushers like, y'all need ushers? I'll be there. Like, I love you. So today has been good. And the nap that we all about to take after this is gonna be good. Yeah, that's gonna be. How many people gonna take a good nap after this? This count as your workout this week, huh? You're looking at your Apple Watch like, oh, 600 cows. Brazil, y'all need to come down to the front. Y'all, somebody grab Brazil and tell him to come experience the praise pit. Yeah, come on, you can't come all the way from Brazil and sit up there. All right. So the food we're gonna eat after this is gonna be good. The nap we're gonna take gonna be good. The shower that all of us need is gonna be good. Okay.
Spectacular. Give me 14 of those.
But the God we serve, He not just good. He's so good. Let's do it.
Now, if y'all believe that, come on, we need all the energy in this building.
Psych.
There are moments and times where you have to time travel, like, and you gotta go back. And my dad used to take all of us on road trips. All five of my brothers, we used to get in a big old van and travel across this country, and him and my mom would minister at all kinds of churches. And it was so crazy. And I love my parents because we would listen to all types of music. They allowed us to be exposed to all types of music. And my dad loved three groups. He loved Earth, Wind, and Fire, the Elements. He loved the Ohio Players, and he loved Parliament Funkadelics. And I know all their music. Like, I know all of their, like, greatest hits, everything. Me and all my brothers could put on an Earth, Wind, and Fire concert right now. Because he wouldn't play anything else on these long trips from L.A. to Philly. And when we got into the session, like, I couldn't deny that all of the songs sounded great, but we needed some old school. And one of the key elements to an old school song, anybody who really knows, is the bass line. Like, you can tell a song, like, if I go boom, 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 I got, you already know the song. You already know the song. Like, the bass line, and I wanted to make a song that the bass line was an old school 60s and 70s bass line, but it drove the whole song. And so all I had to do was say, Matt, And that boy started playing the bass line. Boom, 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 boom. I said, oh no, this thing feels too good. And right when I said it, I was like, oh, God is so good. And we started vibing on this. I said, not a lot of words. Don't put a lot of words. We just gonna define this song that God is so good. And y'all, we started thinking about the grace of God. The way he rescued us. That verse says, like, Lord, you spared my life when I didn't deserve it. How many people, that's your testimony, left the 99 for one, and that's me? I mean, that is me 100 times over. Like, to be able to say that God is so good and to put it to that groove, ooh, it just felt right. I just want people to have a song that they can play when it's so bad, so that you can remember that he is so good. And what you focus on will change how you believe in faith. And today, if you're in a bad situation, don't focus on that situation. Focus on the God that's higher than that situation. Focus on the God that can help you mount up on wings like eagles. Let's focus on the God that will help you wait on him and he will renew your strength. Let's focus on the God who sustains. Let's focus on the God who says, if you wait on me, I'll bring you to the place that you need to, and I will allow what I have in heaven to come down to this earth, and your testimony can be thy kingdom come. All I'm saying is the God we serve is so good.
Now, come on, if y'all believe that, we need to make some noise in this room. Come on, everybody clap your hands. Oh, that sound good to me. Everybody clap your hands. Let's say, you're so good. You're so good. You're so good. Y'all got that? Let me hear y'all try it. Come on. Say, you're so good. Oh, y'all came ready to worship the Lord today. Come on. Say, you're so
good. You're so good.
Whoa.
You're so good. You're so good.
You've been better to me than I could ever be to myself.
You're so good.
So.
You're so good.
So.
You're so good.
down on the one. Here we go. One, two, three. Break it down. Now, we just said that God is so good.
Yes, sir.
And the only reason we can say he's so good is because he's given us something.
Yeah, what did he give us?
You know what he's given us, right?
I think I know what he gave us.
Because it's the thing that he did on the cross.
Yeah.
He gave us
The
V.
I-C-T. Let's go.
Everybody get up, but let's go. Get your bees up. Get your.
Let's go in.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all better turn up. Let's
Everybody get your hands up. We got the bees.
Transform life.
Yeah.